Crank it up, Eric Sparkiness.
Tim Stetzer from Woods Monkey again. We just left SRI World Headquarters. We moved into Blind Horse Knives' new shop. This is Scott Wickham. Scott's the foreman for BHK. He's going to give us a walk through the shop and explain what they're doing down here. Take it away, Scott.
Okay. We moved in a couple months ago to this fantastic new facility, much larger than our previous work spot.
I'm leaving.
That's my main grinder guy right there. Okay, let's
quit. It's quitting time. We caught him at shift change.
Here's an area that we use to finish up the knives. We're kind of doing things backwards here a little bit. This is the last stop before they get packed up and shipped off to customers. This is a board full of heat-treated knives. So that if we get a customer in or we get an emergency build, let's say once they're in this stage right here, depending on the knife, they're approximately 30 or 40 minutes away from a done knife. Scotch-brighted, glue on the scales, sharpen the blade, out the door. There's a variety of models there. Don't look at that, that's top secret. Okay. On down this way. This is the machine we use to stamp all of the horse stamps that you see. And the steel coats get done over here by hand, but this is the press machine that we use to put all our tang stamps on. Dave Canterbury knives, SRI knives, some other project I can't tell you about, all the two different size horses, everything gets done on that little machine right there. More knife blanks. These are back from water jet. Most of these knives, here this is a Brumby, get cut out for us at a water jet facility. And then they get sent here and we flatten them, or stamp them, grind them, get them ready to go to the Peter's heat treat. Here's one of our setup tables and our two main grinders over here against the wall. So things get prepped and laid out and just kind of getting ready to get things done. Here's a bunch of knives that have had one process done. I'll show you this one right here. I don't know if you can see those grind lines on there. This knife has been flattened and we've got the horse stamp on there. Now it's ready to grind. And Justin, the guy that just left, he grinds pretty much everything on this machine right here. This is one of the R.W. Wilson machines that we got a long time ago. Here's the other R.W. Wilson machine. This was LT's machine, but we keep him in the office now. This is our build table, and it kind of goes around in a circle here. We get some scales from this side, clamp the knife on, drill the various holes in the scales, countersink, cut the excess scale material off, grind the front, smooth the front, polish the front, and then it gets set over here for the guy to glue it up. So once it hits this part of the table, the scales are built, they're ready, and then they get glued. I got nothing here because we didn't do that today. We were doing other stuff. But here you can see a bunch of the scale material here.
If you move the Woods Monkey swag out of the way.
We keep scale material cut, so we just grab it, vice grip it to the knife blank, and off we go. Here's a bunch of knives that just need sharpened. This is our third machine. This is one of our newer machines. I mainly use this one, but not all the time. Everything that's in this tray is ready to get sharpened, which we do on this jig right here. Here's a custom for a guy that is sharp. Got to make the sheath for it. Got to do what we call running the front, but it's polished. It's got some oil on it to keep it from rusting, and it is sharp. Every knife that has ever left our shop has been buffed on this machine. All the scales get buffed on there.
Yeah,
run through a couple grits on the grinder to smooth things up, but everything gets buffed on this last machine here. And for quite a while now, everything has gotten sharpened on this machine, and this buffer right over here, this is my favorite right here. This is the final step in sharpening. This felt wheel we use with some green rouge. Every knife that leaves the shop sees this machine before it goes. This is what we put our final polished, sharpened edge on all the knives with. That little
Scooter
machine
right sharp.
There. Scooter sharp, yeah.
Trademarked.
Just another mobile setup table right there. lunchroom with wrappers on the floor. This is our vacuum system, which we don't have hooked up yet. We're going to put it up on a shelf. As soon as it starts getting cold out and we got to keep the door shut, we're going to get the vacuum system going again. There's our bead blast cabinet for when we do a scandi ground knife. We bead blast all the scales, give you a little extra traction. This is our layout table for doing Kydex sheaths and some of the PLSK1 stuff, the KLMS sheath. Nothing fancy here, this little toaster oven, just some supplies there. Our molds, big old vise. Here's our arbor press for doing the rivets. Some extra Kydex floating on. This is extra scale material here. There's a piece of curly maple out of the bin. Just a bunch of extra stuff. More supplies. This is our little router table we use for doing the slide lock. Another one of our bandsaws. And this is a piece of history here. This is a left and right dual direction disc grinder. This is what we used to grind all of the bushcrafters on. Bushcrafters, bush babies. Up to a certain point, everything, all of them were ground on this little machine right here. This is what I first learned to grind on. So if you have one with a curved plunge line, it came off this machine. A little scotch brake belt that we use in making Kydex. This is our Kydex drill press. And this flat sander here we use for a variety of stuff. Sanding the Kydex sheaths, fixing up the scale material before it goes in the box, all kind of stuff. And that big bandsaw there, we use that right now to cut Kydex on. It's a little bit overkill to cut a piece of 60 thousandths thick Kydex, but we're still working on fine-tuning the blade and the speed on it so we can cut everything on that big old machine, but we're getting there. We're getting there. So I think that's it.
All right, man.
There's your shop tour.
Thanks, Scott.
Okay.
This is the Wintersville shop for Blind Horse Knives. Blind Horse operates out of two shops, one in Cambridge, one in Wintersville. This is Wintersville, so this is everything you see. You kind of get an idea of how these guys do stuff start to finish, although we went backwards.
A little bit.
But
we started at the front.
You know, you get to see the inside of the shop. So if you ever wonder how stuff's made, you know, this is where it's done. Maybe we'll come down and actually do some video in process one of these days, too. But you at least get to see where it's done and what they do it on. Thanks for watching, guys.
See ya.